In a thrilling twist of cosmic fate, Japan's Moon Sniper mission has not only successfully landed on the lunar surface, but has unearthed a revelation so profound that even the renowned astrophysicist Michio Kaku finds himself in a state of bewilderment and alarm. As the fifth nation to achieve this remarkable feat, Japan has made history again, showcasing technological prowess that promises to redefine our understanding of space exploration. However, startling discoveries have emerged amidst the celebrations from the moon's barren expanse. What secrets does Japan's mission hold, and what has made Kaku so unnerved? Join us as we unravel why Michio Kaku is panicking over the shocking things Japan saw on the moon. On January 19, the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, JAXA, achieved something incredible. They successfully landed their specially designed probe, SLIM, on the moon's surface. According to Michio Kaku, this was a big deal, because Japan became only the fifth country ever to do this. The journey to this achievement started back in 2005, when they began working on a small satellite for lunar experiments. By 2013, SLIM became one of the main missions for the International Space Station, ISS. Then, in April 2016, SLIM officially became a JAXA project, with Mitsubishi tasked with building the spacecraft. Kaku believes that the main goal of this mission was to test a new landing technology. They wanted to show that they could land very precisely and accurately on the moon. This project was groundbreaking and had the potential to change how we explore space in the future. SLIM's journey to the moon lasted about 4 months, beginning its trip alongside the Gray Imaging and Spectroscopy mission RISM. When it was time to leave RISM behind, SLIM changed its path, aiming to enter the moon's orbit by December 25, 2023. SLIM had gracefully entered lunar orbit, leading to one of the smoothest moon landings ever seen. Kaku explains that landing on the moon has always been tough, because you need to be very precise. This challenge led to the creation of the Smart Lander for Investigating the Moon, SLIM. This new idea used the latest technology to land very accurately on the moon. The success of this mission would show if we could land with incredible accuracy, not just on the moon, but also on other planets. NASA and other space agencies were no longer satisfied with just landing anywhere on the moon. They wanted to land exactly where they planned. Luckily, on January 19, the mission achieved a breakthrough. The lander made a perfectly soft landing right where it was supposed to, marking a huge step forward in our ability to explore space. Despite landing softly, a problem arose with SLIM's power supply. Kaku explains that the solar panel, meant to soak up sunlight for recharging, faced the wrong way after landing, so SLIM couldn't get more power. JAXA's ground crew had to use backup batteries and quickly send two rovers to explore the moon's surface. Meanwhile, the multiband spectroscopic camera, NBC, on SLIM took some pictures, giving us valuable information about the moon's surface. After studying the NBC data, JAXA concluded that the lander wasn't seriously damaged, which was a relief. JAXA decided to leave SLIM on the moon and waited for the sun to adjust its position so the solar panels could charge properly. A lunar day lasts about 14 Earth days, which means there are long periods of sunlight and darkness on the moon. This shows how time on the moon is very different from time on Earth, which makes exploring it quite challenging. At first, JAXA planned to use solar power to operate SLIM for at least 2 weeks. But after the unexpected landing problem, they decided to wait for the end of the lunar day. Once the sun's rays hit the solar panels correctly, JAXA could use the power for SLIM's operations. The way JAXA handled this problem shows that landing precisely on the moon is possible. Kaku pointed out that it also shows that even agencies like NASA face challenges with gentle landings. During NASA's Apollo missions, landing exactly wasn't as important as it is for JAXA. This mission not only shows how advanced technology has become, but also how important it is to be flexible and adaptable when exploring space. According to Kaku, thinking about Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin's experience during the Apollo 11 mission, they faced many challenges when trying to land the lunar capsule. They dealt with communication problems with the base and alarming signals showing that the automatic landing systems weren't working. Armstrong had to take control and guide the module to the surface. But despite his efforts, they ended up in the wrong place. Now compare that to SLIM's landing, which was incredibly precise. Many recent attempts to land on the moon have failed, with spacecraft crashing in the wrong spots. But SLEM descended very carefully, allowing the rovers to be deployed. Imagine a rocket losing one of its engines during flight. In the worst case, it would crash and burn. The best case scenario would be an emergency landing nearby. Despite losing a nozzle, SLEM still landed perfectly on target. Michio Kaku believes that this success has made Japan stand out among countries exploring the moon. It shows Japan's skill and determination in space exploration, setting a high standard for future missions. In the 21st century, only China has successfully landed on the moon. This has made people wonder why modern moon missions struggle with landings when NASA did it 50 years ago. Some think it's because during the space race, the US and Russia competed fiercely to show their power, leading to a lot of money being spent on lunar exploration by NASA with full support from the US government. Today, there's no space race, so lunar missions are mainly driven by curiosity or the desire for historical recognition. This means that modern probes and vehicles often use cheaper materials to save money. Also, many space landers are made by private companies, not government agencies, which can affect their quality. This change shows how space exploration is evolving. When it comes to private companies, their lunar landers have failed every time statistically. For instance, Japan's Hayabusa 2 lander crashed on the moon in 2023. Another problem for landers and probes is the moon itself. Communication is hard because the moon messes with radio signals, causing probes to land in the wrong place. Also, there's no air on the moon, which makes landing tricky. Parachutes don't work like they do on Earth, so the craft's engine is the only way to control it. Pilots have to deal with these challenges while dealing with communication problems. If the probe is too heavy, it will crash. China's Chang'e 3 mission in 2013 was the first successful soft landing on the moon since Russia's Luna 24 in 1976. Many other countries, like Russia, have tried and failed. It was clear that something needed to change to solve these landing problems. Luckily, Japan has come up with a solution. Their new approach could change how we explore the moon, giving us hope for more successful landings and advances in space exploration. The influence of external forces on SLEM's unexpected landing added a new layer of complexity to the mission. JAXA scientists and engineers were puzzled as they tried to understand how this unprecedented event happened, despite the careful planning and design of the probe. Speculative theories about SLEM's unexpected landing twist sparked a wave of speculation not just among scientists, but also among the general public. Some wondered if there were external forces at play, suggesting that something beyond human control might have affected the probe's descent. Others went even further, considering the possibility of extraterrestrial involvement, imagining scenarios where beings from another planet interfered with the mission. The mystery of SLEM's upside-down landing added a new layer of complexity to the mission. JAXA scientists and engineers were puzzled as they tried to understand how this unprecedented event happened, despite the careful planning and design of the probe. Speculative theories about SLEM's unexpected landing twist sparked a wave of speculation not just among scientists, but also among the general public. Some wondered if there were external forces at play, suggesting that something beyond human control might have affected the probe's descent. Others went even further, considering the possibility of extraterrestrial involvement, imagining scenarios where beings from another planet interfered with the mission. The mystery of SLEM's upside-down landing added a new layer of complexity to the mission. JAXA scientists and engineers were puzzled as they tried to understand how this unprecedented event happened, despite the careful planning and design of the probe. Speculative theories about SLEM's unexpected landing twist sparked a wave of speculation not just among scientists, but also among the general public. Some wondered if there were external forces at play, suggesting that something beyond human control might have affected the probe's descent. Others went even further, considering the possibility of extraterrestrial involvement, imagining scenarios where beings from another planet interfered with the mission. Despite all the speculation, JAXA intensified its search for answers, adding more complexity to the puzzle. This quest for understanding not only intrigued scientists, but also captivated space enthusiasts worldwide. To fully understand what happened, JAXA hoped to obtain satellite images, possibly from resources like NASA's Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, to get a clearer picture of the situation. Some features of SLIM's lander and its rovers, despite landing in an unexpected position, managed to achieve some of its goals by deploying two experimental rovers and using as much of its science equipment as possible before its battery ran out. These rovers, called Lunar Excursion Vehicles, LXVs, were unique. LX1 looked like a frog and moved by hopping, while LX2 was shaped like a small ball and transformed into a wheeled camera that moved like a sea turtle on a beach. Interestingly, LX1 successfully communicated with ground stations and even received a test radio signal from LX2. This showed how adaptable and functional the rovers were, giving us valuable insights into future lunar exploration missions. However, JAXA hasn't received any images from LX1 yet. It was LX2 who took a picture of SLIM on the moon. Interestingly, the picture showed that SLIM's thrusters were pointing upwards, which is not how they were supposed to be. Both rovers are currently in standby mode, waiting for the sun to come back and power them up. According to calculations, this should happen around January 31st when the lunar day ends. Building the SLIM spacecraft cost a lot, around 18 billion yen, which is about $120 million. Initially weighing 200 kilograms, its weight increased to 700 kilograms when fully fueled for landing. Developing the LX1 and LX2 rovers was also challenging and expensive. LX2, now called Sorkyu, is especially complex, weighing just 0.25 kilograms. It is the smallest and lightest rover ever made, about the size of a baseball. Developed by JAXA and Sonitomi and Dashisha University, Sorkyu combines toy technology, sensor robotics, and space technology from JAXA, designed to operate autonomously and adapt to the lunar environment. Sorkyu is a remarkable engineering achievement. Shinichiro Sakai, SLIM's project manager, praised the mission, saying, "We've shown that you can land wherever you want, not just where you can." He hopes this success will inspire future Japanese missions to explore new areas of the moon. This technological advance is a major success for Japan's space agency and could lead to further exploration of the moon's far side by probes, rovers, or even astronauts. Japan's mission to the moon was not solely about advancing planetary landing technology, it also had other goals in mind. There's a strong possibility that Japan was also interested in exploring space-based solar power. On January 11, the United States Space Agency revealed a study looking into the feasibility of capturing solar energy in space and sending it to Earth using microwave beams. This new idea aims to create a clean energy source. Although the exact costs are still uncertain, experts see many potential benefits. If space-based solar power works, it could completely change how we produce energy, helping countries reduce their greenhouse gas emissions to zero. This technology could benefit not only the United States, but any country that adopts it. Japan's mission to the moon could be a crucial step towards a future with sustainable energy, showing the country's dedication to innovation and protecting the environment. Capturing solar energy in space is appealing because there's no atmosphere to weaken the sunlight, so it's the purest form of solar energy. The idea of collecting this clean energy and sending it wirelessly to even the most remote places is very exciting. Space agencies like NASA and JAXA are actively working on this technology because they see its potential to change how we get energy around the world. SLIM solar technology has given us valuable information for future projects. However, some people are worried about safety and the high costs of developing and maintaining these systems. Estimates suggest that this new technology could produce energy at 61 cents per kilowatt hour, much higher than the 2 to 5 cents per kilowatt hour of traditional solar plants on Earth. Despite doubts, the idea of creating the ultimate solar energy collector is exciting. But we still wonder if it's practical and truly beneficial. Will it be a sustainable energy solution, or will it just cost governments a lot of money? It's crucial to find a balance between innovation and practicality as we explore the potential of space-based solar power. Recently, there's been a renewed interest in space exploration, with more countries exploring the moon. This has sparked a sense of a new space race. Luckily, JAXA's successful landing with SLIM is paving the way for future space explorers, no matter where they come from. JAXA has announced that they plan to extend SLIM's mission beyond its original goals. They're preparing to gather more technical and scientific data, including high-resolution spectroscopic observations. This will depend on better sunlight and SLIM's recovery through solar power. As we wait for SLIM to start working again in the sunlight, the space exploration community is celebrating this major achievement. It's a triumph that will be remembered in history, showing how far we've come in understanding the universe. We're eagerly anticipating the data SLIM will collect when it's back in the sun, showing the incredible potential of space exploration. The new images captured by SLIM's rover are a testament to the mission's success, providing valuable insights into the lunar surface and paving the way for future discoveries. Despite all the challenges and speculations surrounding SLIM's mission, JAXA has been gaining global recognition since earning the trust of esteemed partners like NASA and the European Space Agency. It played a significant role in constructing the International Space Station, ISS, and is now helping build modules for the Gateway Luna Station, solidifying its position as a reliable collaborator in space exploration. Amidst these efforts, JAXA is planning ambitious missions. The upcoming SLIM landing mission is just the beginning. JAXA is also preparing for a voyage to Mars with its Martian Moon Exploration spacecraft set to launch in 2024. This mission will study the Martian moons, gathering samples and data to deepen our understanding of Mars. For this mission, JAXA will use its powerful H3 launch vehicle. This cutting-edge rocket is fueled by liquid oxygen and hydrogen, boasting three engines in the first stage and one in the second, ensuring efficient propulsion. While the first launch of the H3 rocket in 2023 faced challenges, JAXA is undeterred, planning another flight in February 2024 with hopes for success. Additionally, JAXA is working on New Glenn, an even larger project aimed at exploring Mars. Standing at 98 meters tall, New Glenn is a powerful booster with seven engines in the first stage and two in the second. Its inaugural flight is scheduled for around August 2024. Carrying NASA's ESCAPADE mission. These developments highlight the exciting possibilities in space exploration. Japan's innovative landing technology and NASA's expertise promise a future full of thrilling space missions.